Everybody come looking real fine, fresh from the barbershop, blocking the beautiful line. Everybody running in masses, chilling in the car, they spend all day waxing. But you can't speed 2 miles an hour, so everybody sees you. There's an air of flow, a bit of happiness, and this is the Fresh Prince's new definition of summer.
What's up, Jason?
What's up?
What's going on, man? It's Josh.
Hey, Josh, how you doing? Yeah.
Is that Gerald with you? Who is that?
Thank you. charged to be close to the police. Conversation that we had tonight. We had to have a conversation.
Okay, now it's 4:06. Good afternoon, everyone. Musa.
Greetings from Prince George's County.
If you're like me, you're probably sick of all this stuff. So we welcome you to the 2020 virtual pre-Father's Day cookout and Juneteenth celebration sponsored by the attorney's office. We have a really exciting program for you. We have some guests, the state's attorney. We're gonna hear from the state's attorney, the principal deputy state's attorney, my good friend, Delegate Derek Davis, and a couple of exciting NFL stars we're gonna hear from. So just a few housekeeping matters. If you're gonna show us your grill, you might wanna log on with your phone just to get a better angle, unless you just wanna manipulate your laptop. Please mute your mics, unless you're asked to speak at a certain time or maybe have, if we open up the Q&A at the end, please have your mics muted because there's background noise can interfere with what other people are saying. We want you to ask us questions, comments, things like that. We'll get to as many as we can. Whatever we don't get to, we promise to get back to you within the next 48, 72 hours. You can type questions in the chat box or email me at tamichaelides@co.pg.md.us. I'll read that again to you in a second. We can also text your questions at 240-508-2018, and we are live streaming this event, hashtag PGSAO Men's Event 2020. Again, that's hashtag PGSAO Men's Event 2020. We're looking forward to everyone to seeing what everyone's got on the grill. We're gonna have four winners for the best grill, and they're gonna get some gift cards and a one-on-one Zoom meeting with the state's attorney. Please follow us and follow the state's attorney on social media at PGSAO News.
I'm not eating it.
On IG, Facebook, and Twitter. Again, that's at PGSAO News. And really quickly, I'm going to show you what I got going on here. I don't know if everyone can see or not, but hopefully that doesn't burn there. But we got ribs, some hot dogs, and some corn going on there. So again, this is a really exciting event and a really timely event given that it's Father's Day, Juneteenth, and everything happening in the world. It's an exciting event. So let me not delay us.
I'm doing it every day.
I'm going to introduce you to the chief law enforcement officer of the entire almost 1 million residents of Prince George's County, my boss and friend, state's attorney, Aisha Braveboy.
Thank you so much. Thank you very, very much. I really appreciate that warm introduction. And I wish I had your address. I'd be over there trying to get something off your grill. But thank you all. Thanks.
Are you the keys over there?
Oh, who's talking? Can we mute everyone? Okay. So we just ask that you mute yourself so that, you know, whoever's talking doesn't get interrupted. But thank you all so much for attending. This is our second annual men's event. Last year, we hosted an event at the Woodmore Country Club. But since we couldn't meet in person this year, we decided that we would meet virtually. And I'm so grateful. I just want to point out one thing. We have a real live judge on the line. So I want to say thank you to Judge Sharon Kelsey for joining us today. And we are excited to have you as well on the line with us. But look, you know, this is really about, you know, the men in our lives, the men who make a difference in our communities. And for me personally, the men who make a difference in my office. And so my principal deputy, Jason Abbott, is amazing, as well as all of the other men and women in my office as well. But today we get to focus on the men a little bit. It is Father's Day weekend. And I know that the men in the state's attorney's office put a lot of work in. Oftentimes, it's time that they have to take away from their families to serve our community. So I really wanted to make sure that I highlighted them. I think it's just so amazing that this celebration also falls on Juneteenth, which marks the commemoration of the end of slavery back in 1865. So this day is so meaningful for so many of us. Also today, and I know that we have Captain Boone on the line, and he will You know, he will be giving remarks shortly, but this really today also marks a new day in Prince George's County. As you know, our county executive has selected an interim police chief that will move our county forward. So for so many reasons, this day is so meaningful for our office. So we have a real opportunity for change. And so we look forward to working with Interim Chief Velez and all of the wonderful men and women in the police department, as well as our United Black Police Officers Association, Henlea, and all of the other groups that support the work of the police department. So anyway, I wanna thank my principal deputy, Jason Abbott. He is the coordinator for this event. So you'll hear from him for the most part. Not only does he manage and help me manage an office of over 200 people, but he helps his wife manage a household with five children. So we know that he multitasks a lot and he always gets the job done. We also have my good friend and my delegate, Chairman Derek Davis. He is doing amazing work in Annapolis, and he is the father of two children, and he will, you know, be giving remarks as well. And trust me, he is without a doubt the most powerful person I know in Annapolis. He may not take credit for that, but he knows how to get the job done, and he is he's really represented our county well. So you'll have a chance to hear from him, as well as my new friends, Brian Mitchell, who I have watched probably from just being a little girl. I've watched Brian Mitchell play with the Washington football team, and he is a Super Bowl champion. So we are so happy to have him with us. My father, Cuthbert Braveboy, who's also on the line, is one of your biggest fans, Mr. Mitchell. So I know he's excited to see me, but he's, I think, kind of more excited to see you today. So that's exciting. And I know that you raised four children with your wife. And then we also have Derek Benner, who is also a former NFL player. And he's played on for several teams, including the Oakland Raiders. And he's done a lot of work around criminal justice and reform and work in our communities. So all of these are tremendous athletes and public servants, and also tremendous fathers and husbands. So we appreciate all of you for being here. And if I would just give a special shout out to my father, Cuthbert Braveboy, who immigrated to this country from Grenada and has really built a strong foundation for myself, my sister, and our entire family. So we thank you and all of the other role models in our community. So thanks, everyone. Enjoy your time, and back to you. Oh, am I supposed to be introducing somebody? Oops. Am I introducing Delegate Davis?
Go for it, yes.
Yes.
I apologize. So please help me welcome my really good friend, Chairman of the House Economic Matters Committee, Delegate and Chairman Derek Davis.
Good afternoon, everyone. How are you? I'd like to thank this opportunity. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank my good friend, I wanted to call it Delegate Aisha Braveboy. She served with me in Annapolis for 9 years, but she's moved on to bigger and better things as our state's attorney. So I want to thank State's Attorney Braveboy for putting on this wonderful event. And I too want to wish everyone a happy Juneteenth. Father's Day gives us an opportunity to show and express our love, adoration, and gratitude to all the special fathers out there. On Sunday, I would ask that you recognize these deserving men and have a special place in our lives and their influence upon us. You know, the nation's first Father's Day was actually celebrated 110 years ago to the day. It was June 19, 1910 at a YMCA in Spokane, Washington. And it was first proposed by a young woman by the name of Sonora Smart Dye, who wanted to recognize her father, Civil War veteran William Jefferson Smart, who was a single parent that raised six children. However, it wasn't until 1972, some 58 years after President Wilson made Mother's Day official in 1914 that the day honoring fathers became a nationwide holiday in the United States. So I just wanted to give that little bit of history on the 110th anniversary of Father's Day and also of Juneteenth being today. While Father's Day is a day to pay homage to all fathers, I particularly want to give props to Black fathers out there for holding it down. Too often we hear and see negative portrayals of our Black fathers, but that's not my reality. When I think about fathers, I think about men like my father, Norman Davis, and Mr. Harley, and Mr. Anderson, and Mr. Harrison, the fathers on the street that I grew up on. These are strong, honest, hardworking dads who not only look out for their children, but they do their part to help raise the kids in the village. So as we kick off this celebration, I'd like to also acknowledge our special guest, Brian Mitchell, known to all as B. Mitch, and Prince George's County's own Derek Fenner. And I'd also like to acknowledge all those fathers who are tragically no longer with us, like George Floyd, Philando Castile, Alton Sterling, and Rayshard Brooks, to name a few. God bless to each of you, and let's have a great event.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And now it is my pleasure to introduce my right hand in the office, my principal deputy, Jason Abbott. Jason is an amazing attorney. He is a, just a longtime prosecutor. He led the prosecution of Sean Urbanski, who was the University of Maryland student who killed the Bowie State student and Second Lieutenant Richard Collins III. That was a very tough case. He led that case just beautifully, and we were able to win a first degree murder conviction against Mr. Urbanski. But more than that, around the office, he is a source of comfort for our staff. He works really hard to ensure that everyone has a quality work, it's hard to have a good work-life balance when you're a prosecutor, but he does, the best that we can to ensure that people understand that, yes, we want you to work hard in the office, but we do care about you personally as well. And he brings that level of compassion to the office. And so I really appreciate all of his contributions. And, during this time when I think there's a spotlight and a focus on issues in the justice system, specifically issues that are impacting our Black men in particular, with respect to, things like a use of force, excessive use of force, and discrimination and bias, having someone like Jason to help navigate through those murky waters is so important. So now I will turn it over to my principal deputy, Jason Abbott. The show is yours.
Nasty knives in your area. Whole family favorite. Most mass hysteria. Stay playing the salsa.
Family recipes that went way beyond his Spanish roots.
Thank you, Madam State's Attorney. Thank you for the introduction. Thank you for allowing me to work with you, serve with you. And thank you, everybody who's participating in our second annual men's event. For the Prince George's County State Attorney's Office. This year we went with the virtual cookout. I know where I am, it's raining, but we got cover, we got umbrellas, we got grills going, and it's not gonna stop the show. This is a great opportunity for us to get together to support the youth in our community. And I thank everybody for participating in this, because we want as many people as we can to spread the word that our office is committed to the youth in our community. And we wanna work with y'all, we wanna partner with y'all, we wanna hear what suggestions and ideas you have on how we can leave something behind for the young people that are coming up behind us, because this is gonna be their world, and when it's their turn, we just hope that we leave a message for them. And that's what this is all about. We are gonna have some fun though. We're over here. I got my the Abbott Army behind me. Got my wife, my two daughters, our oldest, Derek. I got the G-Man, Gerald Collins, over there. Everybody's working the grill. I know we got some Kappas in the house. Our oldest Derek is a Kappa. And we're going to have a lot of fun today. I do want to see, I see some people out there that joined us. Madam State's Attorney, I found out this week that one of my friends, Marcellus Baseman Shepard, is another Largo high school graduate, another Lion. And I saw him over there. I see him over there. He's got on some kind of hat. And he's got his own setup going on. So we're definitely going to come back to you, Marcellus, and see what you're doing. You know, Musa has got some time now. He was burning food earlier, but I think he's all right now. He's recovering. I can't wait to see what Perry's doing. Perry Paler, who's another capital on this, you know, he was the one who said, like, this is the idea. This is what we should roll with, this grilling, because he was saying that nobody can compete with him when it comes to doing this. So please, everybody out there that's grilling, upstage Perry, show him up today, please and thank you. But I do like to thank everybody for participating. I like to thank Mr. Brian Mitchell for, you know, donating his time and spending this, joining us with this occasion. Mr. Mitchell, we were going to have a golf event, you know, because I know you, yeah, that golfing is your thing. So we were like, you know what, we're lawyers, so some of us golf a lot. And I was hoping somebody from our office could give you a run for your money. But thank you for participating in this with us. Mr. Fenner, thank you very much. You know, one of Prince George's County's sons joining us with this great event. And I'd like to thank some of the people that worked with us and putting this together early on. I know McKinley Hayes has joined us. I know he's another member of Kappa Alpha Psi. Gerald, where, I mean, a bunch of Kappas out here. but it's a great opportunity, and I'd like to thank you all. And at this time, I would like to also take a moment to introduce one of our speakers, Mr. Derek Fenner, who, as I said, is a native of Prince George's County, a former NFL player, played 9 seasons in the NFL, attended the University of North Carolina, where in 1986, he led the ACC in rushing, known as the Freak from his imposing size and speed, and he still is a very big guy, so he ain't lost nothing yet. Father Time hasn't been too cruel to him, been kind to him. But Mr. Fenner spent his career, played with the Seahawks, played with the Bengals, played with the Raiders, and had an excellent career. And as we talked about, he has also did a lot in this community now. Done a lot for youth organizations, high schools, and colleges. He's taken the skills that he's learned as a professional athlete and translated them into the business world. Does motivational speaking, business development, and corporate teams, and executive training and coaching. All around, great guy. And that's part of what we wanted to present to our youth. Mr. Fenner came from Prince. He embarked on a pro football career, but even after that was over, he's still succeeding and giving back to his community. And the message we wanted to give to all our young people is to continue to stay on your path towards success. The people that are participating in this barbecue, this virtual cookout, have many different paths to success. And so there's no one way, there's no one direction, there's different paths for all of us. And we hope that, I think I got a little feedback now, without further ado,
they're supposed to speak in.
All right, I think we're a little better now. All right. But at this time, I'd like to turn it over to my good friend, Gerald Cowell.
Hey, how's everybody doing? Look, I want to thank Ms. Brave Boy for putting on this timely event. This is clearly an event.
This is clearly an event that we need right now in our community, an event where we can celebrate Black men, celebrate fathers, and just recognize all the good things that we have going on. Before we get further in the program, one of the things we want to do is recognize our partners. We have a lot of groups in the community that recognize the importance of this event. They wanted to come out and help support this event, show their support for men and fathers throughout this country. And so at this point in time, I'd like to shout some of them out. 100 Black Men of Prince George's County, Community Public Awareness Council, United Black Police Officers Association, Firefighter RISE, RISE, the PGC chapter of the International Association of Black Professionals, Iota Phi Theta, Eastern Region, and Alpha Beta Alpha Omega chapter, Phi Beta Sigma, Zeta Chi Sigma chapter, Kappa Alpha Psi, and last but not least, those nasty chew dogs of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated. All right. Glad to have you on here, my brothers. Now, with that being said, I'd like to introduce also one of our guest speakers. This is somebody who, if you're from this area, you don't need an introduction on him. He is a legend in this community. He was a star for my favorite football team as a kid growing up and still is to this day. This is an individual who not only played here, but he's come back and he's contributed to this community many times over. And that person is Brian Mitchell. After a successful 14-year NFL career, former Redskins great Brian Mitchell has embarked on a successful radio and TV career as the co-host of the Midday Show on Team 980, an Urban One radio station. On TV, Brian Mitchell serves as an analyst and co-host of many of the Redskins focused sports shows on NBC Sports Washington, Redskins 100, Countdown to Redskins Training Camp Daily. Brian delivers extensive analysis and commentary covering the top regional and national sports stories daily. As an NFL analyst, he is featured on the network's Washington Redskins game day shows, Redskins Kickoff Live, and Redskins Post Game Live. As a player, Brian Mitchell spent 14 years in the NFL. And during that time, he served as a return specialist and a running back from 1990 to 2003, including 10 seasons right here with the Washington Redskins. He also spent 3 years with the Philadelphia Eagles and one with the New York Giants, but we forgive him for that. We still love him. He didn't play for the Cowboys. In 223 games, he gained more than 23,000 all-purpose yards, which is second on the all-time NFL great list. He recorded 13 career special teams touchdowns, which also ranks second in the NFL. He is a Super Bowl champion with that infamous Redskins team from 1992. Brian was named an NFL All-Pro 3 times, and he was a Pro Bowler in 1995. He was inducted into the Redskins Ring of Fame in 2009 and was named to the team's 70th anniversary team. Brian Mitchell played collegiately at the University of Southwestern Louisiana. We'll have some trivia on that later on, which is now the University of Louisiana at Lafayette. Additionally, Brian is a motivational speaker across the United States, and he's involved in several philanthropic endeavors. I want to thank Brian Mitchell. For a couple of years, he supported the J. Franklin Bourne Bars Association's golf tournament, where we've helped to raise scholarship monies for many students throughout this area, kids who want to engage in law careers. And so he's also helped pave the way for many lawyers throughout this community. With that said, thank you, and Brian Mitchell.
All right, thank you for that introduction. And first of all, I want to just say happy Juneteenth to everybody out there. And happy early Father's Day to all the fathers out there. And because this is a time where, you know, I get kind of happy and sad because my dad is no longer with us, but my dad taught me so much. that leads my way on a daily basis. And but you know, the fact he's not here, that hurts. But ultimately, I want to thank State's Attorney Aisha Brayboy. From the day I met you, I knew I'd be doing something with you. You know, because it's about trying to go out there and make sure you do your job. Jason Abbott, I want to thank you as well, although you're a Cowboys fan. I sent a picture for you. I don't know if you got it or not, about me having more yards against one team than anybody in the history of the NFL, and that's Brian Mitchell against the Dallas Cowboys. I want to thank Delegate Davis also for giving your time, and also Derek Finner, my former my colleague, my NFL player, where because so many times people look at us as athletes and think that all we do is play football. But you know what? We were all human beings before we ever got on the football field. And we were taught all the things that we're trying to teach kids today by our parents and also people in the community. So we try to be that same person as we get out there. So for me, when I was asked to come and be a part of this, and you were talking about inspiring youth and trying to make sure youth understand the right things to do and stand on the same path, you know, one of my favorite poems is The Road Not Taken. You know, two roads diverge in the yellow wood. Sorry, I cannot travel both. Be one travel long. I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bit from the other growth. I believed in doing things differently than everybody else around me did. I wanted to make a difference. And for me, since I was a young kid, I've always done things to make my mom and dad proud. And that's where I live my life today. And I think that as a parent now, because my dad did so much to make me want to be like him, my job is to try to go out there and do positive things to make sure my kids want to follow me. You know, so many times we want kids to respect us. But if we don't do the right things, then they're not going to respect us. So it's about having accountability. And I think when we look at these times today, how things are in this country, how it's coming to fruition, you know, our parents and their parents fought the same things we're fighting today. But ultimately for me is that if we're going to change some things, a lot of us that are the head of our households, the head of our communities, we need to start holding ourselves accountable. And for every young man out there, I want you to live the life to make sure that you go out there and please your mom, your dad, because I've always felt that we do more for others than we would do ourselves. So I say, find that person that you don't want to piss off, that person you don't want to upset, and make sure that you put them in the point where I am here today to try and trying to please that person. And if you're that way, you're going to do a lot of great things in this life, you know, because I have three daughters and I have a son. And I'm not a perfect person, but I think I want to make sure when they think about dad, they think about something good. My 26-year-old is 16 years old. She wrote me a letter and she said if she could ever get a portion of the work ethic that I have, she'll be successful in life. That brought tears to my eyes then and bring tears to my eyes now. So for everybody out there, let's enjoy ourselves here on Juneteenth, because this is the real time when we all knew that we were free. And then make sure you celebrate your fathers this weekend. And everybody out there, let's have an oath to ourselves. We're going to do something just a little bit better today to make this world better. We know that guy in the White House made the comment about make America great again. America's always been great. We're going to make it greater because you know what? We're going to have something to say about it. We're going to have an impact on it, and great things are going to happen. So I appreciate you all for having me. Now I'm going to go outside and I'm going to do what I do best. I cook. I don't know about people around here, what y'all talking about. I'm from Louisiana. We know how to burn, and I'm going to go out here and burn. We'll see what happens later. Thank you all for having me. Appreciate you.
Okay, DJ, play that music.
Is it on? All right. Take it away, Mimi.
Okay, let's give some shout outs. Let's give some shout outs here. Do we have our Tookie Miles, Largo High School alumni?
Yeah, I'm right here.
So, all right, what you got going over there, Mr. Tookie?
Okay, well, listen, I want to say this first.
You come out.
Y'all took a long time. Oh, I got a long recording.
You know what I mean? So.
A lot of stuff is going off the grill, but I got a lot of stuff. I got some stuff for you right here.
What you got? Let me see what you have.
I got some steaks and some shish kebabs left. A little bit of hot dogs left. Everything else is gone. You know, the clan is here. You see them like back there in the background. There they go right there. The clan right, is here.
Did you take a picture, what you did from the start?
No, because it was raining. I was just out here cooking. I was trying to hurry up and get it in, so. I was going to do everything live, but, you know, I'm not really a cook, but I figure I can come on here and I can show the cooks
you know what I mean, what I can do. And I don't know how to cook. So I'm trying to set the bar for the ones who do know how to cook. And I heard B. Mitch say what he said, but I mean, you know, I don't know. I got to see.
Okay, well, let's find another. Let's put the spotlight on somebody else. Let's go to the International Association of Black Professional Firefighters. David Wilson, Assistant Fire Chief. Where are you? Assistant Fire Chief David Wilson, where are you?
This thing. Hey, hello, can you hear me?
Can you there see you me? Are.
All right. We how y'all doing you. Today? I'm Assistant Fire Chief. Just fine. Doing outstanding. I had a couple meetings, getting a late start. I have my wife here. I have my son here. And we're out on our deck off of the kitchen. I didn't feel like doing a big grill today. So we just have a few steaks going. My wife made some deer chops, and we have some corn that's gone and some greens inside, and just a little bit about RISE. RISE is the International Association of Black Professional Firefighters. The Prince George's County chapter is RISE. So RISE stands for Resilient Intellectuals Striving for Excellence, which is what we do. And we collect information from our firefighters to ensure they're being treated as equals on the job, because we all know of days in the past when that didn't happen. So those things haven't completely gone away. Things, we're standing on the shoulders of giants. RISE used to previously be called TASC. That was the, and now that's a retiree group who's still active and still supports us. We currently have about, I'd say about 35 paid members, but about 78 to 80 members that participate in things. So the young people, as Dave Chappelle said, are leading RISE right now. This group has been in effect for about 2 years, and we're so proud of them. But like Dave Chappelle said, I'm comfortable with them driving. And they're the driving force. We're actually taking some pictures tomorrow as a group, and putting together Black firefighter history in Prince George's County. And that'll include you, Mimi. So thank you.
All right. Well, thank you. I certainly appreciate that. There we have it. Okay, we're going to do one more shout out. Looking for Jason Gordon. Jason Gordon, where are you?
I'm right here. My name is Jason Gordon. How's it going? I am I'm a product of Prince George's County Public Schools. I graduated from Oxon Hill High School in 1997. And I'm currently an educator with Prince George's County Public Schools, where I also serve as athletic director at Dr. Henry A. Wise High School. On the grill today, we've got a little pulled pork, and we've got two slabs of ribs left. I'm running late for a cookout. I actually stayed behind just for this event right here, just to make sure that you all can see how I get down. I recently started a grilling catering company called Gordon and Your Grill, LLC. Where you can get you some good grilled meat off of me. I heard Brian Mitchell talking that talk, but he can come by and see me anytime. You may be from Louisiana. I'm from PG, but my dad is from Savannah, Georgia. And that's who I learned it from. So you get the little down home Southern cooking from the grill every time you come by this crib. So thank you all for this opportunity. Again, like I said, I got pork butt right there. And I got two slabs of ribs, one baby back, one St. Louis style. That's what I'm burning with today on my grill.
Nice, thank you. Okay, so we're gonna get back to the program. We're gonna turn it back over to our principal deputy, Jason Abbott. Jason, where are you?
Jason's right here.
Barry is up next.
Jason's right here.
All right, so Perry is up next. So where's Perry?
I'm here.
Perry's hiding from us?
No, I'm on.
Okay, Perry, so I want to know some things about the former NFL players. What you have, Perry? What you got?
Well, right before I do that, I want to talk about the purpose of the event.
Okay, sure.
And the purpose of this event is to encourage and inspire young people to strive for excellence, remain on their path to success, and reflect on the challenging facing young men today. Look, let's be honest. We all know for young people, your lives have been disrupted. We are in the middle of a pandemic. you had to leave your friends at school, your sports, your activities were shut down. You had to leave your church friends and you've been stuck in the house. And it's just unknown circumstances for all young people. On top of that, you've been inundated with violent images of police over and over, brutalizing.
Hey, after Perry get done.
But we just want to let you know, first and foremost, that we recognize all the challenges that you've been going through. And we want to remind you that you are a part of a village, that we care about you. We're here to support you. And our purpose for this event and every day is to get up to make sure you have the opportunity to succeed. So we just want to offer you our best wishes. And please let you know, just because we're virtual, don't think that we're not here for you. We're here to support you. Is that it, Mimi? Now you want to talk about the ball players? Are you muted? But here we go. Let's talk about Brian Mitchell. Well, the Jason and Gerald did an introduction. One thing we wanted to talk about, that he was a quarterback at Southwestern Louisiana State. After retiring from the NFL, he's gotten into television and radio. But one thing that's also important with Brian Mitchell to know is that he does mentoring and he speaks to youth. And he goes around just giving a good message about positive youth development and how to positively impact the lives of young people. Now, we want to talk about Derek Finner. Derek Finner was born and raised here in Prince George's County, and Derek Finner is a graduate of Oxon Hill High School. And I played high school ball around the same time Derek Finner. I remember Derek Finner, and I thought that was somebody's father out there playing. He was the same size at 16 as he is today, and I remember watching those tapes. I'm lucky I had to play against him. But we're just grateful for both Brian and Derek that they took time out to just come to speak to you guys and talk about how they've managed to navigate their path to be the successful men that they are. And Mimi, that's it. I'm gonna kick it back to you guys.
All right, Jason, where are you at, Jason? Where are you? Still putting on that grill?
Oh, okay. You know, like a good father, I've delegated that to my son, to one of my sons. You know, that's how I roll. It's getting hot over that grill. I start sweating. You know what? Son, can you please man that grill for a minute? But yeah, to follow up on what Perry was saying, and you know, it's great to have both Brian Mitchell and Derek Fenner joining us with this. You know, Derek Fenner has done a lot, as we talked about in his introduction, about the his giving back to his community. He also founded the GIK Foundation to help low to median income families, working with people in the first time home buyers. And without further ado, I'd like to present Prince George's County's own Derek Fenner.
Well, Jason, thank you so much for that introduction. I would like to thank State's Attorney Brave Boy and her team for putting this event together. This is an awesome event, and I'm really proud to be a part of it. Like Jason mentioned, I grew up right here in Prince George's County, went to Oxon Hill High School, played football there, then went on to the University of North Carolina, where I got a full ride to play football there. And one of the things that I'm most proud about is the redevelopment of this county. I can recall growing up and going down to what is now the National Harbor and just being nothing but dirt down there. So to come back years later to see sort of the redevelopment of the county really makes me proud to be a part, to say that I'm from Prince George's County. My message today is really simple, because growing up here in Prince George's County, I had some issues and some troubles that I got into. And my message for the youth is really about choices. You know, and staying on your path. A lot of the times, you know, we get off path because we want to hang around our friends. You know, our friends can't go where we go all the time. And what God has for us and it's not for our friends. And for me, you know, I almost lost an opportunity to realize my dream because I allowed my friends to dictate my choices. And those choices almost cost me my life. For those of you who know my story, I spent some time in the Prince George's County jail for a crime that I didn't commit. And I'm very proud that State's Attorney Brave Boy is in the position that she's in because, you know, part of what I do now is justice reform and also obviously social injustice reform. So I'm really big on that. I'm really big in giving back to the community. So I'm proud that she's in that position. But my message to the young folks is that anytime you find yourself caught up in the criminal justice system, there's a chance that you could be found guilty for something that you didn't do. And that was sort of my situation. I was locked up for 44 days and for a crime that I didn't commit. And fortunately for me, I was able to get out of that situation. But unfortunately for me, my football career was kind of put on hold. I lost my scholarship at the University of North Carolina. I went from being a first round draft pick to, you know, not being drafted or potentially not being drafted at all. So as far as economically is concerned, I lost a lot of money there. But more importantly, my name was damaged. My brand was damaged. And, you know, the thing that I say to a lot of the young folks now is, you got to make sure that you're the CEO of your brand. Your brand is important, just like Microsoft, just like Starbucks. You got to make sure that you're the CEO of your brand and you're doing everything that you can do to protect your brand. I get, you know, so frustrated with young men, professional athletes, and, you know, young athletes in college to where they allow themselves to get into situations to where they're behind the eight ball. And it's really an easy thing to do when you don't have the guidance that you should have. So, you know, my job and my objective is to go around the universities and high school and really help young men navigate their way through certain situations. You know, I tell everyone that, you know, I have the blueprint. You know, I've been through some things and I have the blueprint to help you navigate your way through certain situations. So it's an honor to be here on the call. I won't take up a lot of time. Like B. Mitch said, you know, I'm a father of four. I have three boys and a daughter. So, you know, I'm very proud to be in the position that I'm in, to be able to raise my kids and to be able to, you know, kind of teach them and help them navigate their way through life. And so I'm just happy to be here. I am here to help State's Attorney Brave Boy and her team in any way that I can. You know, I'm with my brother who went to Auchin Hill. Listen, we can cook here too. When you don't have to be from Louisiana now. You guys have got me fired up. I may just go fire up my Traeger that I got outside. I was trying to be easy and not get, you know, and not take y'all there. But I think B. Mitch just offered a challenge. And, you know, he put the Louisiana thing out there like, you know, like we don't do anything here in Prince George's County. So I may put you on pause for a second, go fire up the Traeger and throw some crab legs and you know, some chicken and some other things on it and give B. Mitch a run for his money. So. But with that being said, thanks again, Jason. Thanks again, Mimi. Thanks again, State's Attorney Brave Boy. And again, if you guys need me for anything, I will make myself available. I am here to help improve this community. I am 100% at Prince George's County, and I'm excited about where we're going, and I'm excited about things that are happening. So thank you.
Well, let me tell you, been there, Derek, thank you so much again. And I appreciate you making that offer. That's one of the things I wanted to come out of this event is not just to bring us together, but then to make some real positive steps forward. We are looking to expand the diversion programs that we offer in our office. We recognize that not just our children, meaning those who are under 18, but also our young men, our young adults, really need guidance and really need a second chance oftentimes. And so we need to develop more programs and have people like you and Brian and others who are on this line to really come together to develop really a full scale diversion program for some of the offenses that we're seeing in our community, especially around our young men. So I appreciate that. We will be reaching out to you after this meeting to schedule maybe a follow-up where we can invite those groups who may be interested in creating and developing those diversion programs with us. It's going to be an awesome opportunity for us to reduce our prison population, reduce the over-incarceration, the overcharging and over-convictions of young people in our community if we can divert them to something positive with people like you who can really influence them and give them what they need. So I appreciate your offer and we will be taking you up on that very shortly.
Amen.
So listen out for us. We'll be calling you and organizing a real planning meeting around that. So thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Okay. All right. I'm done. Back to you.
that was great, Mr. Fenner. And I echo Ms. Braveboy's sentiments. What you were talking about is what exactly why, you know, we wanted to have this event is to, you know, not only bring people together, but also to enlist people to work with us as we strive to, you know, help our community and help the young people in our community. That being said, I know that there's some other people on here that I know. I can see the Marcellus Baseman Shepard. Can we pan over to Marcellus Baseman Shepard? Because he looks like he's got his game face on. Mr. Fenner, he's another one that I think you should issue the challenge to. B. Mitch, I think this guy, you know, he thinks he's ready as well. He's got his outfit on. He's got his setup. You know, what's up, Baseman?
What's going on? First and foremost, happy Father's Day to all of the fathers out there. Happy Juneteenth to everybody. My name is Marcellus Shepard, also known as the Baseman. Speaking of the brand, I got to put the brand out there. Follow me at The Man with the Voice, Instagram, Facebook. I'm a nationally syndicated broadcaster, voice actor, as well as a professional MC. So if you need an MC for any events, by all means, give me a shout. Got to put that out there. Father of three grown boys that eat like crazy. So I fired up my Traeger, as Derek was talking about. And let me flip this around here so you don't see me. There we go. Look at something a little more. This is my baby right here. I call her Belinda. She's so good. I mean, she makes some good meats, man. Let me tell you. So I kept it simple. I only did two racks of ribs. Already took one rack off, sliced it up. I'll show it to you when we get to the presentation portion, but I used the 3-2-1 method. 3 hours smoked at 165, then turned it up to 225, wrapped them up. These are ready to be sauced, so I'm going to be saucing these bad boys. Look how juicy that is. Lord have mercy on me. And let me tell you, the bone is going to fall right out. Don't worry. I have the bones with the Q's and my alpha. We feed people. So, Q-dogs, I'll throw a bone your way in just a little bit. But that'll be coming to you shortly. That's what I'm doing on the grill. And it's smelling real good out here. I got my wife in the background. It's smelling all of it. She doesn't eat pork, but I did pork ribs today. But, you know, it's all good.
Hey, man, throw that address out. Throw your address out.
777-9311 Elm Street.
I'll see you in 5 minutes.
My man, shout out to all my Largo Half folks out there as well.
Thanks, okay. Man. Thanks, Marcellus.
Yes, yes.
All right, Jason. Before we turn this over to our hashtags and Grill and Meal Spotlight, I do want to put Sade on for about 2 seconds. Sade?
If you are watching this broadcast on Facebook or Twitter, post your pics at hashtag PGSAO Men's Event 2020. We want to see what you're doing. We want to see your meals. So again, if you're watching this on Facebook Live or any other platform, send us your pics. Actually, post your pics using this hashtag, hashtag PGSAO Men's Event 2020. Back to you, Mimi.
Thank you, Sade. All right, it's time for that spotlight again. I'm looking for Sergeant Boone. Where are you? From the United Black Police Officer Association. Sergeant Boone, where are you?
That would be Captain Boone, thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry, Captain Boone. Sorry, Captain. Where is Captain Boone?
Hold them masks down. Hold your mask down. Who thought you come around? Who? Get that trap sound. Trap sound. Go. 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 Go.
Go. Go. Go. Oh, there hello, you are.
Hello. How you doing?
Hello. How are you, Captain Boone? What you got over there? What you cooking?
I don't have much because I'm actually about to go out of town, so I didn't fire up the grill yet.
Oh, okay. All right. Words of wisdom or words of appreciation? What you got?
Okay. Well, you know, first and foremost, good afternoon, everyone. And I would like to thank you for inviting me. Just like we're having a good time out here. I wish I knew some of your addresses because I would definitely make a pit stop before I leave out of town. But I definitely want to just sit back and say thank you. I remember when I first met Madam State's attorney and we were talking about endorsing her and she talked about the diversion programs and things that she would like to do or see differently. We supported her. I really appreciate the support that she's given us throughout this lawsuit that we are, you know, still battling, but she's always been there, been encouraging. And I just really wanted to say thank you to her because, you know, sometimes it's hard out here when you're fighting for others. And I know she knows about that being the state's attorney, but she's definitely been there and definitely has been a light of hope for us. So thank you, state's attorney.
Thank you so much, Captain. You're an inspiration to all of us, so thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Captain Boone. I'm looking for Tasheen Stallings, IOTAs. Is Tasheen out there? Tasheen Stallings, where are you?
I see him.
Okay, we can come back to him.
Okay.
What about Samson? The Cube, woo, woo. Gordon Samson, where are you? Gordon Samson? Okay, let's move on. Mr. Lee, Phil Lee from Community Public Awareness Council. Mr. Phil Lee, are you out there?
I am here, Mimi.
Okay.
How you all doing?
We're doing well. I'm waiting for, oh, there you go.
Oh my goodness.
Watch it. So, in case anybody is wondering, my dear friend, state's attorney is kind of shocked right now, and probably why she didn't mention it, is because I've spent this last 10 weeks at home counting the blades of grass in my backyard. And I've even regrown my 1970 shrub along with my beard. So I've been really having a really good time. I want to say to all of the fathers, I truly appreciate you all doing the things that you do. I'm in the business of monitoring other people's children, and too often that is allowed to be because the fathers are absent. Too many of our Black men are just gone. And that's something that I hope all of you all can help each other to work on. I want to say to Brian Mitchell and the other athletes, my hope is that you all can let those fathers who come see you but won't go to school to see how their child is doing, if you would encourage them to give their children the time that our children need so desperately. For our state's attorney, who's been my friend for about 20 years now, as long as she's done a lot of fantastic things. We've really grown a lot of great things in Prince George's County. And both of us have really devoted our time and our attention to focusing on this thing called diversion. Diversion is late coming to Prince George's County. It's been used countrywide throughout the nation for a lot of years. But not here. So for 20 years, she and I and others have worked to look at how we can divert our children away from the trauma of the criminal justice system. It only takes a set of handcuffs that can change a juvenile's life forever. I am working hard on trying to look for that dynamite, if you will, and I would be asking those other brothers, other fathers, Aisha, who spoke up, because if I can find the right material, I'm going to be asking them to join you and Aisha when we blow up this yard, the prison yard pipeline. That is my intention. My intention is to destroy that pipeline here in our county so it's never again used to funnel our children into the criminal justice system. So it's good to be here. I do want to say this. I've looked at all of the chefs and the little toy barbecue pits they have. I've seen some of them look like they went to Toys R Us and Walmart and picked up a little cheese grill or something. Mine is so I can't even get it all into the screen. But at some point, maybe I'm going to just let everybody see what a real black man's grill setup is supposed to look like. Like somebody else, my number one son is manning the grill. I'm not doing it anymore. I don't even want to stand up that long. So at some point, maybe I'll ask you to come back so we can show the brothers what a black man's grill is supposed to look like. Jason, you and Aisha, you keep doing the things you do. Don't get disconnected from the people of Prince George's County. And speaking of Prince George's County and all of you folks of Prince George's County, let me end with this. I'm from Washington, D.C. I'm an original, okay? Mimi, back to you.
Thank you, Mr. Lee. Thank you. I would like to put the spotlight on Judge Kelsey. Where is she? Judge Kelsey, where are you? We're looking for you right now, Judge Kelsey. There you go. Hey, how are you? You're on mute. I can't hear you.
Yeah, I'm on mute. All right, hold on. Let me see if I can't unmute myself.
There you go. We can hear you now.
You can hear me now?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, well, hello, everybody. Thank you so much. You know, first, I just want to thank Madam State's Attorney for hosting this vitally important event. It's just too often that we just see negative images of our strong men placed in the forefront, while there are so many men who are solid husbands, fathers, and community leaders just all around us. You know, unfortunately, I didn't have the benefit of a male role model in my life, but I'm just so grateful that my girls have my husband, their father, in their lives to guide them in ways that only a father can. Men are not only vital in raising strong young men, but also in ensuring that we have young girls who have the benefit of the male point of view on so many issues. So with that, I join you and the state's attorney in lifting up our fathers and our young black men everywhere. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Judge Kelsey. I want to do one more spotlight before we go to our trivia question. I am looking for McKinley Hayes, Kappa. McKinley, where are you?
In Hamburg, brother.
There you go.
And don't burn it up. Oh, I'm not on, I'm on, let me get on here, Jesus.
Good afternoon, everyone. To State's Attorney Aisha Braveboy, Jason Abbott, staff from the State's Attorney's Office, and the community at large. I am really impressed in what I'm seeing and what I've heard from the special guests from the Maryland General Assembly and the former NFL players. That it's a family here today, that we're working together to become strong, and with the different groups and organizations within our county, as we bridge together, we can become more impactful and make a difference. As mentioned about the pipeline and the other areas of concern, we can work together with the diversion. That definitely sparked me when I heard that word diversion. And if we work with the youth when they're really young and nurture them, that will reduce some of the problems that we have to deal with today. And I would like to thank you again for giving me the opportunity to speak this evening.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Hayes. Mr. Hayes was one of the first people that was, you know, agreeing to be with us, participate, and support us in this event. Thank you very much, Mr. Hayes.
Mr. Hayes, you're come welcome. Hang out with us over here.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, I just want to remind everyone, don't forget to put your questions in the chat box because we will have time to ask questions of our special guests. Don't forget to put questions in the chat box. You can start putting them in the chat box now. And also, we would like for to show some hashtags pics. Can we show some of those now? Can we see some of the pics now, the grill and meal presentation? Okay, so let's go.
Mimi, while we're waiting to see some of that, if we can, I know we can give a shout out to some hashtag Team SAO that's out there. I see we got a bunch of people from the office participating, not on video or on mic, but they're participating. Renee Joy, she should be on video grilling, but she's not. Hey, Renee. Cindy Brisford, I know, is participating. John Naylor is out there.
John Naylor, show that beard.
Yeah, where's it at, John Naylor? I know John Naylor's probably on the grill. Hey, John, how you doing?
How's it going, guys?
Excellent, excellent. Are you on the grill, John?
No, I'm on my computer working. still working.
Look, thank you, John. I appreciate that. Is
on there. That's a good answer. And we got Howard County. We got a representative from the Howard County State's Attorney's Office.
Deputy State's Attorney from Howard County. Is Josh still on there?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm here. How? This is a great event. I'm enjoying it. I'm coming over to your house, Jason.
Come on. Hey, Josh, let us know when y'all's is.
We should do it. I'm going to tell Rich we need to do this. It's a great idea.
Tell Rich we got all the Howard County kids on here.
Oh, I know Chief of Staff Judy Danzo's on here. I saw her. Looking fly. I saw you, Judy.
Where is Judy? Judy's hiding. So let's go to a trivia question. Gerald, what you have for us?
Put the chicken down, Gerald.
Let me put this chicken down real quick. So look, yo, we over here partying for a purpose over here. A lot of y'all real stuffy and got your ties all tight and your shirts buttoned. Look, my shirt buttoned up to the top, but I'm having a good time over here with the Abbott family. You know what, Mimi? Go back to Perry's house. Perry was talking about all this cooking he's doing. It looked like Perry had wine and cheese over there.
No. I asked some food. Gerald, I got this. If you get this question right, I'm going to show you my grill. This is for you, Gerald, and anybody that can answer this. If you're a real Brian Mitchell fan, how many yards did Brian Mitchell have in college as a kick returner and a punt returner in college?
So look, I'm gonna let some of the people.
We gotta include the participants.
All right, and the participants.
I was about to answer that, but I'm gonna let them do it.
We got any responses? I'm checking the chat. In college, how many yards did Brian Mitchell have as a punt returner or a kickoff returner while in college?
Okay. Because I was going to say, it seemed like you don't have no real Redskins fans online today. Nobody's answering the question.
Yeah, you got to be a real fan. Derek Davis put an answer out there. Anybody else? I'm waiting for Gerald. Gerald, oh,
I see. I see what's going on over at Denise Smith's house.
Gerald looking it up on his phone.
Over at Denise Smith's house.
Jay, y'all looking it up. How
no, he won't let me sit down.
All right, here you go.
There we go, Dallas Cowboys. There we go. Thank you, Denise. Oh, no.
Derek Davis lowered his edge. Who else? Somebody else. People looking it up online now.
No, people on Google right now, Perry.
Yeah. So I'm going to get the answer.
Cindy chimed in.
All right, what we got, Cindy? All right, I have the answer. Tell me what I can give the answer. Brian Mitchell, can you give the answer? Is he still on or the rain got him?
Yeah, he's still on.
Brian's cooking.
But he's cooking.
Brian, I'm here. He's cooking for the Paler household.
I'm here. Brian.
I want
Brian
to give Mitchell. You the answer?
Yeah, give it the answer.
The answer is zero.
I was a center in college.
Hey Brian, that's the same number of chickens Perry got on his grill right now.
All right, here we go.
I'm looking for Marcus Hemsley. Where are you? We'll come back to you, Mr. Mitchell. We'll come back.
All right.
Dirty 30 Spices.
There we go.
Marcus Hemsley from the Sigma. No Marcus? Okay. Shane Starling, Iota, are you back yet?
I'm here.
Hey, Tashane, what you got cooking? We doing good. What are you doing?
I was just entertaining my dog at the moment, but I was listening to the conversation that was going on earlier. So I apologize for not being visible at the moment. Happy to get this invite and support my good friend Aisha, and good to see all the other people that's here representing the DC, Maryland, Virginia area.
All right. So you didn't cook anything?
No, I literally just got off work like a few minutes ago. So I've been on a telework assignment all day. So
Perry got
okay,
you.
So-
Yeah, Perry got you.
We will excuse you this time.
Hey, Mimi.
Yes,
I know,
Jason.
Speaking of Virginia, I know we got my man Eddie Pounds, who's participating. He went to the second best university in Virginia.
Ah, okay. Where is Eddie? Where is Eddie Pounds?
Where is Eddie?
You're looking for Eddie Pounds? Okay, we'll come back to Eddie. How about Gordon Sampson? Is he back yet? Okay, so I'm gonna move on.
Who called me?
Gordon. Oh, Mimi Michaelita called you. How are you?
Fine, how are you?
I'm doing well. So what you got going on? Did you cook today?
No.
I'm out of that stage of cooking at the stage. Remember, I was an a principal, and I think I'm a little too early doing all of that.
Well, tell us something about Miss Brayboy when she was in high school. I bet she was in student government, wasn't she?
Oh, she was an outstanding student, very active. I'm not surprised that she is where she is today. And I think the sky's the limit for her. She's always been active. She's always had a great support around her. And she's one of our leaders in our school. And she was, now one of the things you might not know is she was a national cheerleader, because we had she was on the national cheerleading team. I would send you the video of it, but I don't want to embarrass her. let me just say this, the message that's coming forth today is absolutely wonderful. I do want to compliment the Largo High School contingency of the baseman and Aisha, and the Omega attendance with Captain Boone. So I'm very pleased. But I was also excited and glued to the message from the football star Fenner. It was very inspirational. It was very pointed. It gave some direction to our youth. He talked about his past, and when talking about your past, that leads you to your outstanding future, and he had an outstanding future in his family. So again, this cookout, I'm looking around and I'm hearing all of the things that that are being done and all the cooking, and it's inspirational, but it's not inspiration enough for me to go out and fire up a grill. So I'm loving this. I'm going to continue to enjoy it. And I appreciate State's Attorney Brave Boy and all of the men, Brian Mitchell and Derek and others who have participated in this event. So thanks very much. I will continue to enjoy it.
Thank you, Principal Sampson.
You're more than welcome.
Thank you, Principal Sampson.
You sound so innocent.
Is Mr. Brave Boy? Is Mr. Brave Boy on? I need Mr. Brave Boy to back you up. Mr. Brave Boy, are you there?
He's on. I'll have to text him and tell him to queue up so you can move on, and I'll tell him to
okay.
Get ready.
All right. So let's go to a trivia question. Musa, what you have for us?
Sorry, just unmute myself. Okay, we all know our own Brian Mitchell is number one in NFL history in kick return yards. Does anyone know anyone else in the top five? Again, Brian Mitchell is number one with over 14,000 kick return yards. Does anyone know any of the other NFL players that are in the top five? Don't Google it, just see if you know.
Devin Hester,
good guess, but no, I thought that'd be it. I thought Dion maybe too, no? And remember, we're talking kick return, not punt returns. Metcalf was a good guess. Mel Gray, okay. Someone got it. Who said Mel Gray? Tashin Stallings got it.
I did.
Number one is Derek Metcalf. Number two is Allen Rossum. Number three is Josh Cribbs. Four, Mel Gray, and five is Dante Hall. So, but our own Brian Mitchell is number one. So, quick cooking spotlight. Mexican street corn, okay? Get your little corn, put it on the top of the grill. Street corn. A little butter on it, and you put something called elote on it. They sell it at Trader Joe's. It's probably $1 million, but it's worth it. Get that nice, crisp, sweet, buttery flavor to it. That's all I have. Thanks.
Oh, I thought you said. You said elote, is that what that is?
Yes.
Oh, okay. All right, it looks good over there. What you have on your grill though? What are you cooking?
Well, I had to take everything off since I started so early, but this is the last of the ribs. See it there?
Wow.
So one of the things I do is I boil them first, so start to cook a little bit. So the grill is just to get the flavor and get the smoke flavor in it. And not as much to cook it already.
Musa, say that one for Perry.
What's that?
They got Perry. They hungry over there. They're late.
Look, Perry's about to call Red Hot Blue Uber Eats.
Oh, he's a Superman. Oh, yes, he got a Superman grill. All right, so let's hear from, let's go to our questions, Denise Smith, our director of communication. So Denise, let's retrieve a couple of questions from the chat box.
Thank you for taking off that hat, Denise.
I just also wanted to show everything.
See you next week.
I don't have it, right? I just wanted to make sure that we knew that, you know, Gerald, your sisterhood is representing over here.
Yes, BL. Yes.
You know what?
Y'all ready for the kid? I'm ready.
Okay. Ready for the kid. Barry, what are you talking about over there?
They've been calling for me.
Oh, okay, they've been calling for you.
He just got his grocery delivery. Look at him.
They probably gonna have to go to you because I don't think anybody
Cook
has any.
Cook out my peapod. What?
They're gonna need to go to Barry because we don't have any questions in the chat box.
Hey Denise, So my dad is on my phone. He was having trouble getting on. So dad, say hi to everybody.
Yeah, I'm on now.
Oh, there you go. Okay.
What happened to happen? You
Daddy, this is hi to everybody.
Hi, everybody. I hope everyone's having a good time. Typically, of course, we like to get together, but this, well, physically, but at this, these days, we just have to adjust to a new reality.
Let's go
back in.
Can
we take a cure vaccine and we'll get back to full time. In the meantime, I continue to miss everyone. But I guess this is the best we could do.
Thanks, Dad.
Okay.
All right, I'll see you in person on Sunday. We'll socially distance for Father's Day. All right, thank you.
Okay.
All right, gang. You ready?
Yes.
All right, here we go. Oh, this is it. I want you to see it.
We got it. What are we looking at?
How about that? So, look, yeah, right there. Come down a little more.
Oh, man.
We got the little chickens.
We
got the barbecue chicken. Oh, I got the mute on. Y'all hear me?
Now you up at the basement. Oh,
chicken. I got the steak. I got the lamb chop. I got a little salmon for the seafood. If you need a little salmon for
you. This?
Right there. Boom. That's the whole thing. It's your boy, Perry. That's the winning grill right there. All food group. Chicken, steak, lamb chop, seafood.
Yeah,
that's
I see that.
I got my wife out here in the ring, so we got to cut it off short. Y'all know how that is. That's a wrap, baby. I'm out.
So, Perry, can we get your address, Perry?
It's the base man's address.
I thought I saw a Wegman's bag. Did I see a Wegman's bag down there? By
Right. Wegman's delivery. Wegman's delivery.
That's it right there, man. Look, I got my wife right here. She in the rain. She like, that's it. We going in.
She hiding the delivery bag.
All right, so we want to turn it back over to Denise Smith so we can have an opportunity to ask questions.
Oh, well, you can turn it over. You can, I'm going to throw it right back at you, but I will remind you because there are no questions in the chat box. But I did want to remind people that if you do have any questions for the state attorney, for any of our guest speakers, go ahead and throw them in the chat box. We'll come back and address those questions.
Yeah, I
don't
see
it. Okay.
Hey, Mimi, can we also ask folks if they're interested in working with us on expanding our diversion programs and working with some of our existing diversion programs, if they will either email you or put their name in the chat box saying that they would like to partner with us so that when we take Mr. Fenner up on his offer, we have a group that can work with him.
I just wanted to give a shout out to Mr. Hayes from Suitland High School. Hey, Mr. Hayes.
Hi. How are you doing? It's nice Good. Seeing you. Thank you.
Yep.
All right, so let's do some more spotlights. I'm still looking for Mike Lanier. Mike Lanier, where are you? 100 Black Men, where are you, Mike? Mike Lanier, 100 Black Men. All right. How about Chris Osuji? What you doing over there? Did you cook anything on the grill?
No, Mimi. So we're gonna do ours tomorrow, Saturday.
Okay. What are you cooking? What you gonna put on the grill?
Well, we have some steak, some chicken, corn, and some of the good items. So,
okay. So, Ronald Harris, what are you doing over there?
But actually, I'm just sitting there enjoying watching everybody else cooking right now. I'm having fun.
Okay, so Willie Powell, I am at the Powell resident, and he's been on the grill since 4 o'clock. He's ready to show you his grill. There, hey Willie.
Hey, listen. I'm ready. How's everyone doing?
Doing, Willie.
Willie, did you ring a chicken's neck for real? Like,
listen. Hey, listen. I told you, man. We do it fresh over here. You know, we got the wild chicken that's growing, but I'm still putting food on the grill. But I'll show you a little bit of what I have here. Got a little bit of some hamburgers, some kebabs, got some old salmon on the grill, and old sausages. So we've been doing this since early this morning. I've been smoking it, you know, so I do a little bit of cherry wood and hickory wood. But I also just want to, first of all, thank Miss Brave Boy. You know, she putting this together, and it's always a great time to get together for a griller. You know, there's nothing like just being able to get out here and grill in it. We're doing this for a really good cause. Being able to talk to one another, encourage each other as men, and encourage our young people that are coming up too. My wife and stuff, they're out here too. She's out here walking around, and my kids out here playing badminton. So that's what we're doing over here.
Where the chicken?
Mimi's waiting on the food for me now. I got to get her a plate.
Yeah, Willie, I've been sweating over here, you know, doing all this work, and I haven't got my plate yet. But they did offer me a bottle of water, though. They did offer me that, I must say. Okay, so we're looking for Emmerich Peace. Where are you? Is Emmerich back? Not yet. Okay. Oh, there he is. We can't hear you.
We can't hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yes,
we can.
Yes, I am here. How are you?
Okay, Emory, we're doing well. How are you doing?
I'm living the dream.
Are you driving? Are you grilling while you drive?
I just shut up and call and be grateful. That's all.
Okay. So, Emory, we didn't really hear what you had to say. You're going in and out.
Okay. Is that better now?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
So your message to our young people?
My message to the young people is just, you know, be consistent, keep your head up, and stay wise. And the reason why I say be consistent and stay wise is because we pour so much into them at this point in time. They have to figure out how to use it. We can't be with them all the time. We can only impart in them what we want them to have, and what we be the example that we want them to espouse to be, and just be wise. Use your head, because there's so many different options that they have out there, and some are good and some are not so good. And you have to be wise enough to understand what's in your best interest and what's not in your best interest.
Oh, thank you for that. I'm sure those young people really love hearing that. I see Mr. Bobby. I want to put the spotlight on him because he is smiling like really hard. And I want to put the spotlight on Bobby. Hey, Bobby, how are you?
I'm doing pretty good.
That's good. You were smiling, so I just thought that, you know, I will put you on the spotlight. Because I'm strolling through and I just saw this beautiful smile and I said, well, hey, let me spotlight Bobby. So what's going on over there, Bobby?
Well, there ain't nothing going on the grill. I got me some crabs and some fish sandwiches and some french fries. I went to the store. I didn't do nothing on the grill today, but you know, I'm really enjoying the conversation here. I mean, it's really needed. Some of the testimonies I heard. Me, myself, you know, one of the reasons I'm up here because I want to really get involved. I want to be a part of the solution. And so, you know, I've been trying to gather information and doing some research so that, you know, that I can help guide our younger generation in a positive direction. So, you know, God has been good. And, you know, I just like the gentleman just talked about wisdom and making wise decisions and all that. You know, we need to encourage our young people to get into politics and to shape their thinking to be able to bring about new legislation and change. And so, you know, I'm just a citizen and I'm just interested in trying to make that happen. And so I like to, that's about it. That's all I have to say.
Thank you. A lot to say. I love that. Okay, so, you know, there's a lot of people who don't have their cameras on, and I really want to give them a shout out. So we want to see who you are. Rick Gray. Rick Gray, turn your camera on so we can see who you are.
See me?
We can hear you.
No, okay. I don't know what's up with my camera.
Okay.
But
you can still give us some words.
Nice to be here. I'm getting hungry and seeing all that food. I haven't even eaten yet. But just here to show my support and give thanks to all the people in the community.
Thank you. Well,
Mimi, I see my girl Latara Harris.
Yes, ma'am.
Shout out to Latara.
Okay. Latara?
What's up, Latara?
Thank you. Hey, everyone.
Hi, how you doing?
Fantastic. Thank
you. Are you cooking?
No, I'm watching.
Okay. I want to turn this back over to Jason for a moment. Before we move on. Jason, words of wisdom?
Words of wisdom? Sure. Well, always thanks for everybody participating in this. And like we've been saying, like the overall theme is trying to give back to our youth. You know, I'm a father of five. I have three sons, two daughters. It's great, of course. But one of the big things is that I've enjoyed in my life is coaching. I've coached youth sports for the last 16 years. You know, my kids aged out, but I still kept coaching just because I enjoyed so much. I enjoy being around young people, you know, whatever I can give them, whatever little bit they can take is, you know, really why I continue to do it. And it's rewarding. It's rewarding to give back to young people. It's rewarding to have them and to talk to them and to speak with them about what's going on and the work we do in the state's attorney's office. You know, when we, you know, encounter young people, I do see a lot of similarities and, you know, a lot of the kids that I've come into contact with. And, you know, with this event and trying to make sure that, you know, I think it's really important that we do try to leave something, give something back to the young people. And there's a poem that I like that has that same message. I can't memorize it like B. Mitch was able to memorize, but I just wanted to read it to you. And it's about giving back. And the poem says, is anybody happier because you passed his way? Does anybody remember that you spoke to him today? The day is almost over and its toiling time is through. Is there anyone to utter now a kindly word of you? Can you say tonight in parting with a day that's slipping fast that you helped a single brother of the many that you passed? Is a single heart rejoicing over what you did or said? Does the man whose hopes were fading now with courage look? Did you waste the day or lose it? Was it well or sorely spent? Did you leave a trail of kindness or a scar of discontent? As you close your eyes in slumber, do you think God will say, you have earned one more tomorrow by the work you did today? And, you know, that's because we encounter so many people and so many young people, you know, whatever we can do to try to help them and leave something with them is really, you know, important to me. It's really important to Ms. Brave Boy. It's really important to our office. It's what she has brought to our office and how we engage with our community, especially with the youth in our community. And we look forward to working with all of you in trying to, you know, continue to keep that message, but also practice it, also put our actions to it. So thank you very much. Mimi, back to you.
Right.
Okay, so we're gonna go back to the chat box. So Denise have questions. that people want to ask of our guest speaker. So Denise, you're back. I mean, you're on.
Hello, hello. So the first question that I have, and maybe, and I'm sure the state's attorney, how can we help with the diversion program? What is it that you need?
So we're in the process of identifying some of the offenses that we'd like to create diversion options for. And so what we would like is to get your contact information, have a follow-up meeting so that we can begin to put in place a comprehensive diversion program to address things specifically around homelessness. Also, what we also find is that some of our assaults are occurring because people don't know how to resolve conflicts. And so instead of always, you know, like taking those cases and trying those cases, there may be community mediation or some other options that we can look at. So that's so those are some of the things that I know that we are focusing on, reducing the number of people exposed to the criminal justice system, or really to prosecution. Certainly when they come to us, it's because they've been arrested. But if we can create a good diversion option for them with the help of you all in our community, we can restore them and make sure that they don't commit offenses in the future. But conflict resolution, managing anger, these are some issues that we see over and over again in our communities. And we really need your expertise and your experience to assist us with our young men. So again, we're gonna have a separate follow-up meeting for that, but we're hoping that all of you who have an interest can maybe get together and we can create one comprehensive diversion program to address some of these issues.
Thank you, State's Attorney, Madam State. So we have another question for our speakers that used to play in the NFL. Wants to know if you would be interested in working with Prince George's County-based small businesses with youth reform. Not sure.
Who is that message for? Can't hear.
Sorry about that. So the question is, would you be interested in working with Prince George's County-based small businesses with on youth reform?
Yes, definitely.
So I think what we can do, that question came from Mark. Mark, if what you can do is you can send us your contact information in the chat box. I'll jot it down and we'll make sure that we pass that information on to Mr. Mitchell.
Okay, cool.
Yep, and connect you guys, okay?
That'd be perfect.
Thank you. The next question. So Mr. Wilson, so the question was, how can RISE, did you have something else? So the next question was, how can RISE participate in the diversion program? So I'm just gonna, and Madam State, if you just want me to just ask them to, if you could just drop your contact information in the chat box, I'll jot it down. We'll make sure that we connect with you for those very important initiatives. Thank you very much for inquiring and for volunteering. Let's see. Okay, I think Mimi, I think you can take it away and we'll, I'm gonna check your text messages, Mimi, please, thanks.
Okay, so back to the spotlight. Kevin Ampofo, is Kevin Ampofo? Kevin, are you out there? All right, what about Tyresia McCall? Tyresia McCall, are you out there? Okay, we can move on. Okay, Mike, give us some music for a second, please. Thank you, Mike. Ed Barrows, where are you? Spotlight on Ed Barrows.
Hello. I can't see my. Oh yeah. Hey. Hey, Manny.
How you doing?
I'm trying to convince my brother to join me. He's in the living room playing his video games.
Okay, well, while we're waiting for your brother, how about giving some words of, hey, brother.
Yeah. Okay, he's gone already. But thank you for joining us, Manny. But no, I just want to say thank you to all the fathers out there. I want to give a shout out to my very own dad. I'm recording this for him because he's at work until 8 o'clock tonight. Like many fathers, he's an unsung hero in my family. He always goes above and beyond to model what he expects from me and my siblings. He works very hard, and he's worked very hard from ever since I can remember. I'm always working two jobs, always doing whatever he could to make sure that my family was okay, including providing nonstop guidance and direction, both solicited and unsolicited advice. Outside of all the advice that he's given me over the years, what I've learned most from him has very little to do about what he's actually said, but more so to do with the example that he lives every day. I know we have some NFL champs on the call. I put in my notes that I consider my dad a champ because he has certainly beat the odds from growing up in Valley Green to getting caught up in the criminal justice system to coming out and living a wonderful life and ensuring that myself, my mother, and my siblings also have a great life. And so I love you, Dad. I appreciate you. And so, yeah, those are my remarks. And also, there was a lot of Divine Nine talk on the call, but I have a couple of brothers of Alpha Pi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated on the line as well. So I just want to say hello to my brothers.
Hello, Alpha. How are you guys out there? Okay, let's hear from Franklin Shelton. He works in the state's attorney's office. Franklin, where are you?
Yeah.
Okay, the spotlight on Franklin. Franklin Shelton.
He's coming on.
I see. There he is.
Oh, hey, Franklin. Love that background.
Take yourself off mute.
Franklin, you cooking out?
Okay, there we go. Is that better?
Yeah, there we go.
Hello, everyone. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers out here. It's a wonderful program.
Franklin, are you at the courthouse outside grilling?
You cooking at the courthouse?
Yeah, are you cooking at the courthouse?
Yeah, come join me. That's there's plenty of space.
Oh, because I thought the courthouse was still closed.
See, Franklin's from Tennessee. I thought they knew how to cook in Tennessee.
Of course. You know, my ears have been cringing listening to some of the techniques you guys have been discussing, but, you know.
You say Perry, right? You talk about Perry? You talk about Perry.
But it's good. It's for a good cause. So I let everybody show their skills.
Mimi, where do I pick up my trophy?
Not yet, Perry. Hold your horses, Perry. Just hold your horses. Can we get some of those hashtags picks, please? Hashtags pick. We really want to see what everybody has cooked today because we're getting close to, 6 o'clock. We still have 15 more minutes left, but we do want to see some of the picks from the hashtag because we do want to choose our winner and announce them at the end of this program.
Mimi, let me.
Mimi, I said several of them. I tried to hashtag y'all to death.
Wow, nice, nice.
Oh, I like that. There you go.
Hey, that was Cowboys.
I was getting used to that. I got to have on my hat.
Love that star. Love that star.
Yeah. I guess I'm built a little
different. They happy to switch it. Okay, next pick. Food in the kitchen. I go to the Grammy. No likes and no mix. These
characters on and I really don't get it. I hear what they on. I've been here for a minute. Don't speak on Molly.
Mitchell, are you taking selfies?
No, are you taking I was reading a comment. That's all I was reading the comment.
I want to see how good you are with doing a selfie. How about you turn your phone and then take a picture of the people in the background? Oh, okay.
Over here?
Oh, thank you. Well, let me show off my plate that Mr. Powell fits for me. Let me show you guys.
You want me to take a picture of my people here or the people on the phone?
Yeah. Well, I want you all to see this plate that, well, you can take a picture of, you know, the people on the phone, the people where you are, whatever you want to do. But I want you guys to see my plate before you do all that now. I want to show you guys what Willie did. He works in the state's attorney's office. And I tell you what, they are really cooking today on that grill.
Mimi, we kind of lost you.
Let's see if you have skills.
Mimi, bandwidth is low.
Yeah, Mimi, you out there in the country. Your bandwidth low.
Yeah. I'm still kicking running around out there.
Hi, Felix.
Oh, wow.
Take yourself off mute, Felix.
Can I see this plate?
So Felix is part of our multicultural team. Hi.
Is that Harry?
Hey, take yourself off mute. You gotta take yourself off mute.
Okay, there you go.
Yay!
I'm wearing a hat of a trooper because I want to honor our first responders.
Oh, awesome.
I've been showing this to my students, you know, when we had our virtual, learning, which just ended this week.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you so much. Thanks for joining us. Yeah. I came out on the grill today, huh?
It's an honor, my dear state's attorney. And I whispered to you, you know, when we were at the National Harbor.
Yes, I remember.
So thank you for having me here today.
Thank you. Thanks for joining us.
Okay, so someone asked for the hashtag again to post pictures. So it's hashtag PGSAO Men's Event 2020. Hashtag PGSAO Men's Event 2020.
Did I just see Harry Huff?
Harry Huff?
No, not that's really.
Let's put the spotlight on Harry Huff. Hey, Harry, how you doing? What are you cooking?
I was on my way over to Harry. Get my plate that Willie owes me.
Oh, well, Willie cooked some good food here, so I can't eat yet until I get off this program. And I'm so hungry. Okay. Now, I see Mark. Mark and Maria. Mark and Maria, where are you? Mark and Maria Johnson, looking for you. Hey, Mark, how you doing?
Hello. This is very inspiring, but this is me. How you all doing? I'm a Prince George's County based certified business. I'm inspired by what the Prince George's County state's attorney is doing, and we want to make a difference. And want to make a difference with what you've done with this network, and we think we have some great ideas.
Thanks, Mark.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you, man.
I forgot to tell you, I am kind of shy. So, but thank you for spotlighting me.
What's up, Mark? Mark, what's up, man? Good to see you.
You too, sir. I look forward to doing some things with the state's attorney since I've been here since 1965. Oh, I forgot to highlight that my grandfather is Horace and Dickey, Fish Place, and the guy who said they were from D.C. So we want to see if we can do some things from a great standpoint with the youth. So I have, again, 7 children, 17 grandchildren, and they're looking to be highlighted. And they want to, and we have a lot of youth that wants to speak out and be part of a solution. So thank you so much, Ice Brave Boy, for your youth reform. And you know, our entire family love you. That's it.
Sir, hey, Mimi?
Yes, sir.
Madam State's Attorney, do you think that we could maybe bring all of the youth groups together at one time?
Yeah, we can do that.
We can go to the park, play softball.
Softball, wait, we, after the pandemic.
No, we can use the bat to knock the pandemic away. but hopefully, if you all start planning it now, because it'll take some time. But I think it would be great if we begin to unite, and especially those children that are in D.C. I just think it's a good idea. We got to stop doing things and so we got to start showing a united front. And this is a good way to do it.
I like it. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I think we have a superstar on the line. Walter Kirkland has joined us.
Ah.
Hey, Mr. Kirkland. Is he? Can he see us?
Yeah, he can see us.
He may not be frozen. On. Oh, he's frozen?
Yeah.
All right. Well, hopefully he can, chime in shortly.
We'll come back to him. George Cooper, looking for George Cooper, District 5 Coffee Club.
Can you hear me
George
okay?
George Cooper, are you there?
Can you hear me okay?
Yes.
I am. Can you hear me okay?
We can hear you.
Yeah.
There you are.
Right. Good evening, everyone, and happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there. Mimi, I did want to give it to you, and Ms. Brave Boy, you guys are doing an outstanding job in the community. We are so excited. I know these young folks, trying to educate them and get them on the right path, and we definitely need that. I just want to kudos to you guys for sure. And I just want to share with you that we are getting ready to do something similar to this on July the 9th. We're going to have a Zoom panel as well with young folks ages 14 and up. And I might be reaching out to you guys for one of your attorney to sit on the panel with us, if that's okay. I'll give you more information on that. But I did just want to say kudos to you guys and what you're doing. You're doing a great job. Please keep it up.
Thank you.
Thank you, George. Okay, so.
So is Mr. Kirkland available now?
Well, I sure am. I sure am. How you doing? Can you hear me?
Yes.
I am driving, so sorry for me driving, but Aisha, what can I say? You have been an incredible community leader. You've been very supportive with the 100 Black Men of Prince George's County. Anytime we call, you're always there. You're doing a yeoman's job in your current role. So just congratulations to you. Anytime we need us to support you, please lean on us. And we really appreciate your leadership in the county. Thanks for letting us be a part of this great event in this virtual world that we live in right now.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Walter.
You're welcome.
Tell Stephanie
hi. I will.
Hey, Mimi. Real quick, I got a
I got to show some love to my son, Dad. He's been the one on the ground.
Okay.
Ground.
How y'all doing?
What you been doing?
He said he was going to the
girl. Looking on right now, so I don't want to upstage Ryan Mitchell. It's his show, so I just want to have fun while I'm doing.
Okay, so what I want to do, I do want to now announce
hey, Mimi.
Our winners. I only seen a few. Yes.
Hey, can we shout out one other person?
Yeah, we got to. Got to.
What's my man Todd Stewart?
Todd Stewart is on there. Go right ahead.
We saw him on there.
Where's Todd?
Is Todd still on?
He's on here.
I know.
He's on. All right.
My man Todd Stewart.
Todd Stewart.
Todd, you working?
No.
That's
how Todd dresses in the basement.
Take yourself off me.
He's in the man cave.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, Todd.
Hello, how are you doing?
Awesome. I guess you're not grilling at the courthouse, huh?
No, I'm not. Not. I'd have to answer to Tillerson Adams if I were. I got some popcorn going now. So, yes, ma'am. It was a great event. Thank you very much.
Happy Father's Day, Todd. I love
you. Father's Day.
Hey, happy Father's Day, Todd.
I know Liz Selson is out
there. She's out on Bitcoin.
Hi, Hilda. I see you. Just wanted to say hello, Hilda. And to Tamika Patterson. Hey, Tamika. Oh, I also see Ellis Watson. Hi, Ellis. Thanks for joining us.
Victoria Adegoke in the house.
I see Chris and Suji, but I don't see his grill. What's up with Suji's grill?
Well, he's going to cook out tomorrow.
Yeah, tomorrow.
That's right. Come by tomorrow.
Hi, Joyce Beckham. Hi, Joyce.
Harry trying to deflect.
Oh, I see my girl, Crystal Hollingsworth. Hi, Crystal.
All right. So, Amani, can we pan on everyone?
Yeah, we gotta see how this ended up. We gotta see what B Mitch.
Oh, is that?
Let's see what the bass man did.
Was that?
Hi, Sir Brave Boy.
All right. So before we go today, I want to see more of our pictures. Our hashtag pictures. Are there any more hashtag pictures? Okay.
Mimi.
Crystal Hollingsworth. Crystal Hollingsworth, where are you?
Mimi, can you guys hear me?
Mimi has low bandwidth.
Can you hear me?
We can hear you.
Hi, everybody. This is an awesome idea. This is so creative. Hello. Hi.
Thanks for joining us, Crystal.
This is an amazing idea. This was very creative. I see one of my clients on the line, Mr. Darwin Kemp, is on here.
Hi, Darwin.
What a great idea.
Thanks.
Is this going to be recorded? I would love to go back. I got on a little bit late. I had a Juneteenth event that I participated with. So is this going to be recorded where we can come back on and look at the beginning?
It is recorded, right, Imani?
Mr. Evans!
Yes, it is recorded.
Thank
you.
Hey, how you doing?
Okay, yes, so it is recorded. So I think we can make a link or something available to everyone who's participated. So we'll send it out.
Thank you so much. Hi, Miss Mimi. Hi.
Thank you, Crystal. Hi. How are you?
I know we're at 6:01. So how do you want to do this so that we can get folks off? Because I know they need to.
So before we, yes, before we close out. So Ms. Brayboy, closing remarks from you. Closing remarks from Delegate Davis. And also, we want to show a Father's Day video.
Oh, very nice.
Okay, I'll be quick. Thank you all for coming. We'll be following up with those of you who are interested in participating in our diversion expansion. And I appreciate everyone. And in particular, I want to say thank you to our amazing host, my principal deputy, Jason Abbott. Thank you. Oh, and my entire team, oh, by the way, who's in the background is Mike Hall and Amani Blake, and they do, they make this whole thing work. And so they work with Mimi to and Denise to make all of this possible. So thank you so much for all your work in the background. We really appreciate that. So that's all I have to say. And happy Father's Day to everybody.
Thank you. Okay. And Mimi, real quick.
Delegate Davis.
I'll be real quick. Once again, thank you all very much for having me. This is a wonderful event. Yeah. I've enjoyed myself tremendously. Thank you to all the guests who've appeared and shared their insights and thoughts. Everyone enjoy Juneteenth and have a great Father's Day.
Okay, Jason, give me just two more minutes. I want closing remarks.
Two more minutes, real. And all I wanted to say was thank you to you, Mimi, for everything you did on this and the whole committee. You know, my man Gerald Collins, Perry Parler, Musa, Ed, Sade, you know, doing her thing, Denise, Nisi, Amani, Mike Hall, everybody who, you know, worked on putting this event together. It was great. I do want to see what
Jason, you wait a minute, hold on, Jason, you stole my thunder. But anyways, let me hear some remarks from Derek Fenner and Brian Mitchell. Closing remarks from Mr. Fenner first and then Brian Mitchell.
Well, first of all, again, happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there, and happy Juneteenth Day to everyone as well. This was a tremendous, tremendous event. I'm very fortunate and happy to be a part of it. I look forward to working with State's Attorney Brayboy and the rest of her team on future events. And like I said previously, I will make myself available to make sure Prince George's County stays the best county in all of the country.
And I'd like to say, I'll be right there with you, Derek. Anytime Ms. Brayboy needs someone out there, I'll definitely be there. And I'll just say this, you know, the momentum that we have right now, we're looking at this as a crucial time to where we have the opportunity now to change a lot of things for our people moving forward. And I think we have to make sure we seize it. And everybody on here, make sure you tell somebody about this event and make sure everybody else go out there, continue doing this to make sure we're going to be motivating young people, also doing things to make sure we give ourselves a better opportunity to be very productive in this life that we have here. So again, happy Juneteenth, happy Father's Day. Everybody enjoy yourself. And I heard everybody that challenged me in the cookie thing, I want you. Bring it.
Hey, B. Mitch, real quick, B. Mitch. I heard you like to cycle.
Yeah.
So I want to get with you to cycle and also to play some golf. I'm not really good at golf. I just started about 3 years ago. But okay. I heard you was the man on the course. So I want to get with you to play some golf. I gave my number to Mimi to shoot to you.
Okay,
so
cool.
Let's get together and talk about it.
All right, we'll definitely get that. Let's do that, all man. Right, I think cool. We could take the cycling and do some great things for the county as well because,
yes,
you know, you got 5Ks. Why not ride 50, 60, 70 miles and raise money for a good cause as well?
Absolutely. Cool. Absolutely.
Okay, all right, that sounds like a team SAO along with our former NFL football players. So I'm pretty sure the team SAO can get some good cyclists out there with you guys.
All right.
So we're going to be joining you. How about that?
Let's do
okay, that. So one last thing. I'd like to end this with a Father's Day video. But first of all, although Jason stole my thunder, I would like to still thank the committee, Jason Abbott, he was the host, of course. Sade Dennis, Gerald Collins, Musa Eubanks, Denise Smith, Perry Paler, Ed Barrows, Niecy Draper, and most importantly, Amani Blake and Mike Hall. Thank you guys. I certainly appreciate you. I can't tell you how much I appreciate you. So now we're gonna start with the Father's Day video, and happy Father's Day to all you great fathers out there.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
The video, Mike.
Amen.
All the kings who father, this is for you.
Put the hands up to the sky.
Love is a beautiful thing. Can you cool my flavor? Love is a wonderful.